Yo, what's good, y'all? We back in here with another banger. And this video is something I want to make because, I mean, it's my channel at the end of the day, so why not? You know what I'm saying? I just feel the need to talk Knicks once in a while, you know, vent. This is like me venting on the issues that I have with this team. But it's not going to really be a team thing. This is more so just directed to be a topic about their starting five. And I just want to talk about it because I rant about this every single Knick game that I watch. Haven't missed a game. Every single game, besides probably the first game of the season, or maybe, after, you know what, let's say after the first five games of the season. Ever since then, I've been complaining about the starting five. It's bad. It's really bad. They just played Chicago. They lost. Julius Randle finally had a good game. Everybody else, nothing. Nothing at all. Every night they run out the same lineup of Kemba Walker, Evan Fournier, RJ Barrett, Randle, and Mitchell Robinson. And you would probably think, oh, that's a solid starting five on paper. Definitely better than last year, right? You would think. But as of right now, it's actually worse. It's so bad that it's one of the worst starting fives in NBA history. When it comes to plus minus, it's that bad. The confusing thing about this whole situation is, in the preseason, things looked so beautiful. It was like a free-flowing offense, ball movement, high volume of three-point attempts, but they were also going in. But right now, it's just they have absolutely no chemistry. The three-point attempts are getting ridiculous. Tonight, not as much, but in general, it's ridiculous. It's just a slow, stagnant offense with lots of Julius Randle ISOs, and it just makes no sense. Randle has easily been one of the biggest issues right now with the backcourt of Fournier and Walker. Each night, every night, these guys are playing bad. Almost every night. Randle has had, he had a good game tonight, but I'm saying in general, he's been playing bad. Fournier and Walker just have been horrible. I don't care how much Walker's getting paid. He's barely getting paid anything compared to what his actual big contract was. But still, he's not even living up to the, what, $8 million that the Knicks are giving him? It's that bad. Fournier and Walker refuse to be on the attack almost every game. And Julius Randle is attempting a high rate of contested jump shots. Like, why is he 6'9", 250 pounds? Tonight, he had Alex Caruso and Lonzo Ball on him multiple times. And settled about 3 to 4 times for contested step back jump shots. Why? He played a great game today. I'm not going to hate on him. I'm not even hating on him. But why is that a thing? I don't care how comfortable you are with those shots. You are 6'9", 250 with guards on you. That's bad shot selection. Like if we were in 2K, that's a bad shot selection. 3 games ago, he attempted 11 shots. 10 of those 11 shots were threes. I don't get what type of game plan, what type of shot selection he's on. I don't know what he's doing. Then Tibbs is also killing this starting five by not opening up any creative playbook schemes. Like, what are they doing? What is Tibbs doing on offense? Why is it such a slow-paced clown show for the first and third quarters? It's bad. The whole starting five's energy is just off. They look so bad in general. You know, multiple times you saw them slacking, guys not playing no defense. The bench has saved them multiple times this season. And it sucks because the starting five looks so good on offense in the preseason and for like the first 6 games of the year. Now, they can't do nothing. Defensively, this is one of the worst starting fives in basketball. RJ Barrett is the only guy that can guard a perimeter player on ball in this lineup. And he's not even the greatest defender. He's a bad off-ball defender. Solid on-ball defender, but he's not athletic like that. Everybody else doesn't play defense. Julius Randle, who played well last year on defense, gives no effort. And Kemba and Fournier are not known for defense at all. And it's just the liabilities because of their lack of athleticism and effort when you look at the starting lineup. Kemba Walker, not athletic. He's shifty, and I don't know if you want to say that's athleticism, but you know, he's 6'1". He's like 6 feet. 5'11", 6 feet. Evan Fournier is not athletic. RJ Barrett is stiff, slow, not athletic. Julius Randle, you know, he's mobile for his size, but doesn't give effort. Mitchell Robinson's athletic, but, you know, he's really just a paint presence and he's a lob threat on offense. So there's not much you can say about him because he does his job. Is it at an elite level? No, but he does it at a good enough level. The only problem with him is he's just not on the floor enough. He's constantly hurt 24/7. But as of right now, when your top guys or your starters are taking you out of games, there eventually has to be adjustments made. Right now, Evan Fournier is straight up robbing the Knicks, robbing James Dolan of money. He's robbing him. This is highway robbery what he's doing right now, bro. This man shot, I don't know how much he shot tonight, but he didn't even shoot well at all. He had a solid game in the Houston game before the Chicago one on Saturday. That's cool. I thought we were going to have something good. He didn't do nothing. Played horrible. You know, if you're not making shots and you're not playing defense, I see why Tibbs doesn't play him in the fourth quarter. Tibbs has been killing the Knicks this year. He killed us tonight. But, you know, when it comes to Fournier's minutes and Walker's minutes, I see why it's tricky. Because they play no defense. But, you know, another thing is they play no defense, but offensively they're not doing nothing. So there's no point of playing them at times. There's no point. The only problem I have is that he doesn't play some of the young guys like Grimes, who is a first-round pick that doesn't play at all. And RJ Barrett played horrible tonight. Still didn't play Grimes, but that's not really the topic of this video. And I think this is one of the most disappointing starting fives in the league. You know, this team should not be 9-8. When you look at the schedule, they had the third easiest schedule before the Chicago game. Third easiest, and they were 9-7 going into this game. That's bad. And now they got the hardest schedule. And they're 9-8 after losing tonight. What can you say? It's disappointing. This team should be way better. They got a super tough schedule coming up. Let's see if they could turn it up and find something. I mean, they did win a third quarter. The starting lineup did win a third quarter tonight, which was a first in like, I don't know how many games. But hopefully they can find a groove because the chemistry has been off. They need to find a groove on offense and get them inspired on defense. Hopefully them getting a groove on offense can get them inspired on defense because right now it's just bad. It's inexcusable. And as a Knicks fan, watching them play every game is cringeworthy. It's bad. I can't watch this starting five play much longer if they're going to keep doing this. I can't watch Evan Fournier rob my team like this, bro. I can't watch it. You know, I can't watch Kemba Walker get paid $8 million to score 7 points. And he's a known scorer. I can't do it. I need better. Anyways, that's going to do it. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Also, follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Link will be in the description. This has been The Checkup, where we talk hoops and hoops only. And I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.